I would welcome anyone from outside of Manor to come to Manor, Texas, to come and see our school, to see our campus, to see some of the great things that are going on here at Manor High School. Because we have some amazing things going on right here in front of me in this interview process. I'm assuming this is Mr. Pruitt's class. Am I right?
Sure.
So, definitely got great things going on here.
Just because of this incident, it doesn't mean that our school is necessarily like that all the time. There's things that we're doing to make the students more comfortable in school, like providing more officers and having more activities after school so that they can participate in them and not get into trouble. So there's a lot of things that we're trying to do.
Well, let's see, we've just had a lot of negative publicity lately, and negative publicity sells papers and it makes people tune into the news, but it's definitely not the whole story. And anybody that goes to school here, works here, sees so many great things happening every day. I hope that they would not judge Manor on just the small number of negative events that have been reported, and judge us by what really happens here.
Very hectic day. Many fights I heard, and what I know, we had to stay in class and go to a restaurant.
Really good pep rally. First homecoming dance that most of y'all can remember ever having at Manor High School. We had the Juniors for Change conference, and we're setting up more for the other grades. But it's like everybody came to school on Monday with just a really, really positive attitude. And it just, I don't know, it seemed like we had finally gotten the students together in a peaceful setting and had a good time, and then all of a sudden, you know, before the first bell rings on Monday, 10 girls decided to fight over a boy, and that's what gets the most attention. It's a little disappointing, I guess, is the best word to say. And it doesn't, I think what the news has been reporting doesn't reflect what's actually happening at the high school. That seems to be what's dominating everybody's ideas about this high school now.
It sort of did. It gave us a chance to do more work and to follow up on what we've been missing. But at the same time, it took a lot of time for my other classes, which wasn't good because I had some tests in third period. And so that just disrupted everything.
Like when I had to go to the restroom, whatever my teachers would tell me was to stay. And then that made me just be like, well, I might as well get this work done. You know what I'm saying?
Is that in our lifetime, certain events happen, and those events have a domino effect on how we react. Now, the events that occurred, we were already in the process of changing the dress code because we felt like we really needed to. But as they occurred, that only ramped it up even further. So we have an obligation to ensure the safety and security of all of our students, all of our staff here. And that's why we have to do it. It's not that we're trying to make life miserable for you. We gotta make it safe. We have to create a safe learning environment. You talk about what can the kids, you know, how can I ensure the learning goes on? That's how we do. We have to create a safe learning environment for our students. And so that, you know, that's kind of how I try to roll that out about how we need to change the dress code and all that. So hopefully that makes sense to everybody.